Next, we talk about the lump sum principle. The lump sum principle say that, okay, the income tax is always preferred to the per unit tax if the tax amount is the same at the respective perspective of the consumers. So that means consumer always prefer the income tax rather than tax on the specific goods. Well, we can use the indifference curve analysis to show this result, okay? Say the per unit tax. Per unit tax is the tax charged on the goods. Say the X is charged on T of the tax rate. So the budget constraint will become like this. So if the amount of income tax is the same, the budget constraint will become I minus TX. Okay, so this X, you need to find the optimal X star. As a result, okay, you can get the same amount of tax. Then we can see that in this case, the income tax can generate higher utility than the per unit tax. So first, let's use a diagram to show this. Okay, so this is the original budget constraint. Now, if there is a per unit tax charged on the good X, so the budget line will rotate inwards, okay, inward. Then you can find the optimal X and Y by the intersection of the indifference curve and the budget line. Okay, so next, you need to show with the same amount of tax, the income tax is always preferred to the per unit tax. Okay, so if the consumer is charged an income tax, the budget line will parallelly shift inwards because the relative price between the X and Y does not change. Okay, so the optimal amount is here. So the new budget line should cross the original consumption bundle to show that, okay, the tax amount is the same. So this will parallelly shift in to here. Okay, so this is I minus TX star derived by PX. This is I minus TX star derived by PY. Okay, then here you can see that the consumer can reallocate the optimal consumption of X and Y such that, okay, he or she can achieve a higher utility level. So here, U1 is higher than U0, showing that, okay, the consumer prefer the income tax to the per unit tax. So this is how you use the diagram to show the result. You can also use mathematics, okay. So say, we have a Cobb-Douglas utility functions. So in the previous video, we shows that X is AI over BX, while Y is 1 minus AI over BY. So we put here, we can see that A is 0.5, while 1 minus A is also 0.5. So optimal X is I over 2BX, and optimal Y is I over 2PY. And if we put into the indirect utility function, we will get I over 2PX raised to the power 0.5 and PY raised to the power 0.5. I just replace X to be here, Y to be here, okay, and I get the indirect utility functions. Why I use the indirect utility functions? Because the income tax and per unit tax is something that changing the income or PX. So the indirect utility function can directly check what is the changes in the utility. Okay, so assume PX is 1 YOP, Y is 4, and income is 8, okay? And we can see that the utility level is 2 times. Okay, you just plug in the value. And this is 2. And the unit of the utility is called utils, okay? But this is not that important in this stage. So the utility is 2. If there is an income tax of $1 on good eggs, so this is the per unit tax, the utility will become 8 over 2 times. Now P of X become 2. Okay, then the indirect utility level is 1.41. Okay. So let's continue. So if there is an income tax, so first you need to show what is the amount of the tax should be charged. The budget consumed become I minus TX star, which is equal to 8 minus what is TX star. So you need to test what is the new optimal X star. The new optimal X star is equal to I 8 over 2 times PX. Now the price of X is 2 in the income tax case. So the optimal X star is 2. Therefore the income tax is equal to $1 times 2. 2 units of good eggs. So the new budget constraint, the new income after tax income is $6. As a result, the V is equal to income 6 divided by 2 times 1 raised to the power 0.5 and 4 PY raised to the power 0.5, and the utility level is 1.5. Okay, here is how you use mathematics to show that income tax is preferred to per unit tax. Okay, unless there is a perfect complement, because you have to buy the same combination of X and Y. Otherwise, the income tax is always preferred to the per unit tax at the perspective of a consumer, given the tax amount is the same. So next is the expenditure function part. First, we talk about the expenditure minimizations. So in the past, we usually, given the budget constraint, and select the highest utility level. But in fact, another same problem is that, okay, the same way to find the answer is that you are given one utility level and you are trying to minimize the expenditure. Okay, so this level of expenditure is too much, and this level is too little. Okay, so you can minimize the expenditure by achieving the same utility level by selecting the minimum expenditure, and we call this expenditure minimizations. So to achieve the highest utility, you can first give it the budget constraint, then select the highest utility, and this is the same as given the utility level and you try to minimize the expenditure. Okay, so the expenditure function is given by P1x1 plus P2x2 plus up to PnxN. So this is the same as your income functions, and the problem is trying to minimize this expenditure subjected to the utility level on the selected utility levels. Okay, let me give you an example. Again, the Cobb Douglas. Well, how to find the expenditure functions? So you should start from the indirect utility functions. Since expenditure function is equal to the income, okay, so you just need to multiply both sides by the denominator. So the expenditure function is just equal to Px 0.5 to Py raised to the power 0.5 times the utility function U. So this expenditure function is very useful because this can directly shows that, okay, if there's change in good increase in Px, okay, and in the past you would think that, okay, increase in Px will lower the utility level, but here give you the direct way to shows that, okay, if Px increase and if I want to keep the utility constant, how many expenditure should I be given to compensate the increase in price of good X? Okay, so if you do run E run Px, you will get Py Px raised to the power 1/2 times the utility level. So this shows that if Px increased by some amount, in order to keep the utility constant, the expenditure should increase by this amount, such that the utility level can keep constant. Okay. So this is the intuition behind the expenditure minimizations. Lastly is the property of the expenditure functions. So there are some properties for the expenditure function. First, expenditure function is homogeneous of degree 1. Homogeneous of degree 1 means that, okay, now I know that expenditure function is a function of P1, P2, up to Pn and I. Okay. Up to Pn. So if I multiply P1, P2, and P3 up to Pm by T, okay, so this is exactly equal to T raised to the power 1 times the expenditure function of P1, P2 up to Pn. So this is called homogeneous of degree 1. Next one is non-decreasing in price. So that means the first order conditions is always non-negative. So this is reasonable because the price of the goods increase should not decrease the expenditure, because you still have to buy something on it. Okay. Finally, this is concave in price. So again, this is reasonable. So this shows that the expenditure function given the PI is concave. So it will not be a straight line. A straight line represents that, okay, if the price increase, your expenditure also increase. But the concave shows that if price of certain goods increase, you will substitute it by the other goods. As a result, the increase in expenditure may not be just a linear function. Okay, so this shows the substitution effect. So this shows the substitution power in the expenditure functions.